I read The Hunger Games very early, like, you know, right when it was published, and immediately fell in love. And then I heard, because of course I thought this has to be a movie, and then I heard that Nina Jacobson, who's a producer extraordinaire, already had the rights and that they were going to be sold to Lionsgate. I mean, the whole thing was like, I called everyone I knew the minute that I knew that they were making a movie of it. And then Gary and I worked together on Seabiscuit. So when he got the directing job, I just sent him a little email like, just so you know, I'll totally play Effie. And Gary went through his process. And a long time later, after we had a couple more conversations, here we are. Well, Effie, I mean, frankly, Effie is very much my personality too. You know, she's the comic relief in a lot of ways. She's a very flamboyant person, but she's also, I think, she's very scared. She's clearly in tune with the oppression going on around her. And, you know, she's someone who travels to the district, so she sees firsthand exactly what's going on. Whereas I think most of the capital citizens live in bliss. You know, ignorance is bliss, and they just don't know. And Effie actually takes the trains and goes to District 12, and she's been doing it for years. And you know, she plays in the world of the Hunger Games, and I think she's very knowledgeable that at any moment, as much as the lives of these kids are at stake, you know, her lifestyle is at stake as well. Effie is sort of like the publicist for this district, District 12, which is normally a district that loses. We haven't had a winner or a victor since Haymitch Abernathy, who is an old drunk played by Woody Harrelson. And so I'm not very hopeful when I see these two, Katniss and Peeta, that I have a winning team this year either. The relationship between Effie and Katniss is rather cool, I would say, because and from her perspective, I can understand it because I am a resident of the Capitol and she is a meager resident of District 12. But from my perspective, Effie's perspective, I am doing everything in my power to help her win, and she just doesn't realize it because she's petulant. Well, the Oscar nominee Jennifer Lawrence is playing Katniss Everdeen. She's just amazing. I think she's got a real vulnerability and depth to her that just pops out on screen. She's beautiful, and you totally root for her. And I mean, when we did the reaping scene, she literally brought tears to my eyes every take. She's just doing an amazing job. I think everyone's gonna be thrilled. Woody Harrelson plays Haymitch. Why is Woody Harrelson a great Haymitch? I mean, I think if you could bottle Haymitch and shake it up and pour it out and make a human, it would be Woody Harrelson. Gary Ross, the director, is, I think, just an amazing storyteller. You know, he's Oscar nominated as well, and for good reason. He loves telling a great story. He sees it visually, which is really fantastic. And he's very good at sort of communicating to everybody and collaborating with all the sort of artists. And the other great thing is he's really brought together an amazing group of people. I mean, Phil Messina, the production designer, Judianna Makovsky, the costume designer. We just have the most amazing team working on the movie. And then he's just has so much taste. And you know, you really want that. You really want to protect this material. And that's what Gary is doing best. He's protecting the books. The world of the Capitol is, you know, it's so interesting because once you're here, you can't really imagine anything else. And Gary, I think, is really running this theme throughout here about sort of concrete and power and control. You know, everything is about control. And so all the spaces that we're in are very sort of, they're amazingly big and lavish, and at the same time completely constricting and airless, and it feels like you're in a prison. You just feels like you're in a really fancy prison. And I think that's exactly what the Capitol should feel like, a really fancy prison. As an actor, anytime we can make a highly entertaining movie that's also extremely thought-provoking, that is a win all the way around. I mean, that's why I do this job, and that's what The Hunger Games is all about.